Hello everyone. Myself, Atomo Roy, from Hebrew University, Jerusalem. This is my topic of presentation today, which you can see. But before going into the detail of this project, let us discuss about one thing that we are facing the challenges of energy. The amount of energy we are getting from fossil fuels, they will diminish very soon in the recent future. So what we have to do? We have to move forward towards the renewable energy sources. And we can see that already the use of renewable energy is increasing. And we can see that it is increasing, and in recent future, it will increase to very high. We can say that. But we have some problem with renewable energy. Two main problems. One is conversion of renewable energy. Another is storage of this renewable energy. So, for renewable energy, we need solar energy, tidal energy, or wind energy. So, first we need to convert those energy into electrical energy. Then we have to store them in some different storage. In this work project, my focus is the storage part. Two most commonly used storage, one is battery and another is supercapacitor. We all know. For battery, what is seen? That battery has very high energy density, though power density is low. If we see the supercapacitor, then supercapacitor has low energy density, but its power density is very high. Is it possible to combine both these things? Oh, we can try maybe. One of the possible approaches to combine battery material and supercapacitor material together to form a battery supercapacitor hybrid. But how we can do this? Now we can take, suppose a capacitor type material graphite, then we can exfoliate that graphite. The graphite can be exfoliated in many different ways. Maybe chemically, electrochemically, even physically also. So, if we exfoliate the graphite, we will be able to separate the each and individual graphite layers. So, these graphite layers, they are actually capacitive. Now, if we are able to deposit some battery-type material in between those capacitive layers, then it is possible to get the battery and capacitor hybrid thing. So, our goal is to synthesize, deposit cobalt manganese layered double hydroxide, which is battery material, into the three-dimensional graphite, which I told earlier. So before going into my project, let us discuss a bit about that layered double hydroxide. It is a multi-metal clay-like material which has this type of structure, layered structure. Now question arises, why I choose this layered structure? One, because as a capacitive material, I am choosing graphite, which is also two-dimensional. So I thought that if we choose two-dimensional material, then it will be better for our performance. And moreover, we can tune the performance of layered double hydroxide by tuning its cations. And we can also, without altering the structure, so it will be layered. Still, we will be able to vary its electrochemical property. So, what I need to get this? But here I mentioned two parts. One is exfoliation of graphite, another part is deposition of layered double hydroxide. In our work, we combine both these things together. How we did this? We did this synthesis in a conventional three-cell electrochemical deposition system. Here we used cobalt manganese salt. This cobalt salt not only act as the source of cobalt in cobalt manganese, but also it acts as the, what I can say, exfoliating agent at high negative potential. It helps in exfoliation. Then we have performed cyclic volumetry to get the layered structure. And if we see, this is our sample. After exfoliation of that, and if we elongate that, it will be like this one. So what we did, have did this or not, we have done this or not. We check the scanning electron microscope first. If we check the ACM of that material, graphite, now left one is the ACM of graphite, while the right one is the deposition after deposited sample. So what we can see that we have deposited something on the graphite surface. So on the surface we have deposited layer of hydroxide. Then we have performed the X-ray diffraction of that electrode, and what we see? We see that all the prominent peaks of cobalt manganese, the leach is there. And further, to study the composition and whether it is cobalt manganese or leach, we have performed the X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy. And in X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy, we observe that multiple oxidation states of both cobalt and manganese is there, which means that it may be a good material for energy storage, as we have multiple oxidation states of these materials. But still now, what you talk, all are surface. So we have deposited on surface, but whether we are able to separate those layers and penetrate the metal, we check this, we have performed cross-sectional SPM of that material. And if you see here, we take a cross-section of our material and we went into the depth up to 8 micrometer. And what we can see? We can see that cobalt, manganese are there. We have successfully able to deposit cobalt and manganese inside the layer. And on the TEM, we can see that we have also able to separate the graphite layers. So we can say that we have succeeded to exfoliate the graphite as well as deposit cobalt manganese LDH. But what about the its performance, energy storage performance? So to check this, we first perform the cyclic voltammetry of that material. And in cyclic voltammetry, what we see? We see a nearly rectangular cyclic voltammetry curve with two redox peaks. So that means we have the capacitive type rectangular peak, which is superimposed with the Faraday type redox peak. So to check that, this is only visible, so we need to do some mathematical calculation or some measurement to see this. For that, we have performed the power law. According to this law, the current is proportional to standard of some function, you can see, and the factor B. Depending upon this factor, we can say the type of the material. For example, if B is 1, then the material is capacitive type, and if B is 0.5, then it will be current. So we perform the power law of our material, and what we see, that slope is 0.85. So numerically now we can say that we have both contribution from double capacitive part as well as the Faraday part also. But we need to differentiate how much is capacitive and how much is the battery type. So to do this, we have performed two different methods. One suggested by Doom. According to Doom, the total current is the sum of capacitive current as well as the battery type current or Faraday current. So using this equation, we have performed. And what we see, that one third of this contribution is due to Faraday or battery type contribution. And another method we can use to check, that is suggested by Tracetin. According to Tracetin, the total capacitance is the sum of capacitance due to inner layer and due to outer layer. By outer layer, we mean the capacity, but where does the inner layer include the Faraday or battery type part? Here also we see that in the second graph, the capacitance from outer layer, or that capacity part is 1.21. That is exactly 2/3 of that what you got. So this agree with what you got in Doom. But not only the cyclic voltammetry, we have performed the galvanometric charge display of our material as well. and this galvanostatic charge discharge curve, this also agrees with what we got in cyclic photometry. This curve is also nearly triangular with small distortion. This distortion is due mainly because of this Faraday curve. And here we can see that we get a high specific resistance of 210 millifarad per centimeter square. This is quite high this type of material. And we need to check the material, whether this material is good for long cycle or not. For that, we have performed that long cyclicity of this material up to 3000 cycles. And after 3000 charge discharge cycle, what you get 90%, it retains. So we can use it for long term application as well. We have performed the electrochemical impedance spectroscopy of this same material. This is the electrochemical impedance spectroscopy image of this material. What you can see at small frequency, there are two semicircular parts and the small frequency, the high frequency that is magnified. So you can see that there are two semicircular parts which arise due to two interfaces. One that graphite and layered double hydroxide, another is layered double hydroxide and the electrolyte. So for these two interfaces, we got two semicircular parts. And then in the mid frequency region, we have some little bit of diffusion limited part. And finally, the curve is almost parallel to y axis. That is, we have capacitive contribution also. And we have performed the mod plot of that same material. And what we see, we got the similar trend. So finally, we can conclude that we are succeeded to exfoliate the graphite foil in the form of three-dimensional layer. And we also able to deposit cobalt manganese LDH not only on the surface but also inside it, inside the layers also. And electrochemical performance of this material is also very good. And in future we can use this material for flexible energy storage. Thank you.
A lot. Any questions? Have you thought of it?
Did you calculate the capacitance per gram of electrode material?
Not yet. We have not calculated that per gram, but we have calculated per unit area and per unit volume also.
Okay, so let's thank the speaker again.